General Ambassador Power, Excellencies, dear Nadia, ladies and gentlemen, I regret that I could not be with you in person for this very special event to present extraordinary young woman, Miss Nadia Murad Besitaha, as UNODC Goodwill Ambassador for the Dignity of Survivors of Human Trafficking. I would like to offer my deepest thanks to the Secretary General, Ambassador Power, and Mrs. Amal Clooney. I would also like to thank all of the trafficking survivors who are taking part in this event today and who, like Nadia, have overcome unimaginable suffering to devote themselves to helping others. Dear Nadia, first of all, thank you. Giving a voice to trafficking survivors is absolutely essential to raising awareness of this terrible crime and to bringing the perpetrators to justice. I know that your extraordinary commitment can move people to action, and I look forward to meeting and working with you again on Monday at the Summit for Refugees and Migrants. The terrible vulnerability of people on the move to the predations of criminals has never been clearer. We must act. I have great hope that this groundbreaking summit can help the international community to do more to protect and assist trafficking victims and other many children, women, and men subject to violence, abuse, and exploitation. To date, 169 state parties have ratified the protocol, and 156 countries have made human trafficking a specific criminal offense. But as Nadia can tragically bear witness, the international community's efforts continue to fall short. We need governments to redouble action by and between states to ensure that vulnerable people do not continue to fall victims to human traffickers. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I encourage you to do what you can to support survivors like Nadia by honoring commitments under the Protocol Against Trafficking and through your contributions to the UN Voluntary Trust Fund for Victims of Trafficking in Persons, especially women and children. UNODC is ready to support you in all these endeavors. I thank you.
Yours is a very different kind of ambassadorship. Unlike celebrities who put to noble public use their fame and personal understanding of a topical cause, you bring with you for this mission the hardest of credentials, the record of personal suffering, your courage, and your dignity. Unlike most of the statesmen and high decision makers you are to meet, you have seen the ugly face of our enemy. You looked the inhumanity of slavery in the very eye. This is why we think